Hey guys, this is David from Next Earth, and today I'm going to go into the deepest rabbit hole we've ever been to, one of the most complicated ideas that we've ever built, and that is the Nth Dimension Layers. It's so sci-fi sounding even just by the name of it, and it's actually not a coincidence. So when we talk about a metaverse of a million businesses, how are we going to onboard a million, 10 million different businesses on top of Next Earth? What we actually talk about is our platform as a service offering, which consists of a bunch of things. So when I talk about PaaS, we have the API suite, which is an application programming interface. And that means that any developer can come in, access to the API, get the necessary documentation through our dev portal, and they can actually start using our Web3 infrastructure within their own software application without having to build everything. They can just connect to our existing application and use our assets, use our resources. In return, all the revenue that they generate will actually generate the revenue share for us. Part of it will go for a token burn, and another part of it will go for the staking reward pool. Apart from the API, we will also have a sandbox environment, and this is different from Sandbox the company. This is a technical term in engineering that basically allows you to try out all the different features of the API without actually having to launch your application. So this is going to be the sandbox. And the third one is what we call the Nth Dimension Layers. Now, how does that work? So when you look at the Next Earth platform, what you can see is a map and a grid. And this is where Nth Layers or Nth Dimension Layers come into play. Because let's see an example. So you have a map, and these are 8 tiles on the Next Earth map. And let's select these 2 specific tiles that are important for us for some reason. The technical solution would be for any developer to allow them to create their own layer on top of this map, where they can actually have the equivalent of this specific 2 tiles. So they can also mark it as important. Now what happens is that these 2 areas will be joined together. So this is the map, and this is, let's say, layer N. This is what you create as a developer. And when you create your own layer, what actually happens is that you will create specific properties that can be enabled or disabled for specific geolocations. So for example, if you're Starbucks, and this is a Starbucks, and that is also another Starbucks shop, cafe, what you can do is that you can say that on the Starbucks layer, these are the only 2 tiles that actually exist. This one doesn't exist, and these ones don't exist either. So what you can do is say, for every single tile that is on a Starbucks cafe, it's generating loyalty points. When you get 10 loyalty points at a Starbucks, you get a free coffee. And then they can create their own application using this geolocation data based on the Next Earth map on their own mobile application without ever having to deal with NFTs or wallets or anything else. However, they can still leverage the benefits of using Web3 technology, because then users can buy and sell and trade these different tiles that actually belong to a Starbucks-based application. Now, why is this important? It's important because it's scalable. So when we can keep building this technology, we can actually scale it up to even like 10 million different layers without ever having to deal with the scalability issue, because you're not trying to visualize all of them all at once. You can have a layer-based view through Next Earth, when you can launch all sorts of applications that are using Next Earth, but you don't have to. And that's really important, because let's say what happens when this is not Starbucks, when that is actually a 3D layer built by a 3D visualization company that starts building 3D rendered versions of the planet So at first they create a layer where they select the oceans. So at first they're going to create 3D rendered versions of oceans. So they make sure that all these red tiles are ocean tiles and everything else is inactive. Then let's say they build forests in a 3D render. So then they also activate forests. And then you can start roaming around and using that 3D layer that is based on Next Earth. What happens if another 3D visualization company comes to Next Earth? They can also create their own layers, and now you actually have two different options to choose from if you want to roam around in a 3D environment. Same goes with avatars. You can choose from all sorts of different service providers. With Next Earth technology and the Nth Dimension Layers, we are enabling not just one specific use case or just one specific service provider to provide something like avatars or 3D environments or specific use cases for specific large corporations, but we can actually onboard all of them. So let's give you an example using our first launchpad project, RisingStar. RisingStar is creating an AR/VR based metaverse run Netflix, right? Netflix for the metaverse, where your favorite celebrities and athletes and all sorts of different people and teams can actually be watched in any kind of locations using augmented reality and virtual reality technology. Now, what happens if what you actually want to do is that you want to watch a concert that was recorded by a RisingStar, but in a specific location? This is when these Nth Dimension Layers and even the 3D environments can come in. Because on the RisingStar layer, people can create 3D rendered versions of specific locations, stadiums, concert halls, the White House, the Eiffel Tower. It doesn't really matter. Anything can be 3D rendered and then put it behind the actual celebrity that is performing a concert. What that means for celebrities is that they can perform a concert all at the same time in every single one of the concert locations on the planet. They can perform at multiple venues all at the same time using the Next Earth Metaverse and RisingStar technology. For you as a user, it enables what we call concert hopping, which is a concept that I think is fascinating. Because these concerts will be totally interactive, that means that all the visitors to the concert, the audience will actually determine through DAO votes where the direction of the concert, what should happen, what should the celebrity do next. That means that no two concerts will be the same experience. And if you feel like that the concert is not going in the direction you want to see where you're watching it at the White House, you can decide to hop over to the one that is happening at the Eiffel Tower and see how's that going, because that's a different one. Same celebrity happening at the same time, but it's a different experience. And this is when we're just breaking down all the physical boundaries powered by the metaverse. These are the kinds of examples that show us how technology can be used to create next generation experiences and enable all sorts of different economic relationships between consumers and creators that have never been seen before.